Good morning, children. I am teacher Shobha. Let us learn about how people choose to live in a place. Look at the map. All the places marked with the triangles are sites from which archaeologists have found evidence from hunters and gatherers. Hunters and gatherers lived in many places. Only some are shown in this map. Some lived in Bhimteka, and some in Hunski, and some in Karnool Caves. Many sites were located near sources of water, such as rivers and lakes, because water is very much needed for all the purpose, and this is the main source to survive for all the living things. So people started living near rivers and lakes. As stone tools were important, people tried to find places where good quality stone was easily available. They used stones as tools for many purposes like cutting and digging the ground, etc. We can see many rock paintings on these caves. Can you describe a painting with what does it mean? Some men are hunting animals. Many of the caves in which these early people lived have paintings on the walls. Some of the best examples are from Madhya Pradesh and southern Uttar Pradesh. These paintings show many wild animals drawn with great accuracy and skill. Sites. Sites are the places where the remains of the things which ancient people used, such as tools, pots and buildings, were found in these sites. These were made, used and left behind by people. These may be found on the surface of the earth and buried under the earth or sometimes even under water. Let us refer the Karnool Caves. Some traces of ash have been found here. Ashes of burnt wood, and this suggests that people were familiar with the use of fire. Fire could have been used for many things, as a source of light, to roast meat and to scare away animals. Animals usually don't come near fire. So can you suggest what do we use fire for today? We use fire for cooking, heating water and melting metals. And there was a changing in environment. Around 12,000 years ago, there were major changes in the climate of the world, with the shift to relatively warm conditions. In many areas, this led to the development of grasslands. This led to an increase in the number of deer, antelope, goat, sheep and cattle, that is animals that survived on grass. And those who hunted these animals now followed them, learning about their food habits and their breeding seasons. This helped people to start thinking about herding and rearing these animals themselves. Herding and rearing means taking care of animals and feeding them. Fishing also became important. Now let us learn about the beginning of farming and herding. There was a time when several grain-bearing grasses, including wheat, barley and rice, grew naturally in different parts of the subcontinent. Men, women and children collected these grains as food and learnt where they grew and where they ripened. This may have led them to think about growing plants on their own. In this way, people became farmers. And people could also attract and tame the animals by leaving food for them near their shelters. And the first animal to be tamed was the wild ancestor of the dog. Later, people encouraged animals that were relatively gentle to come near the camps where they lived or near their houses. These animals, such as sheep, goat, cattle and also the pig, lived in herds and in groups, and most of them ate grass. People protected these animals from attacks by other wild animals. This is how they became herders. By the time when people became herders and started farming, they started domesticating animals. Now, what is domestication? This is the name given to the process in which people grow plants and look after animals. Very often, plants and animals that are tended by people became different from wild plants and animals. This is because people select plants and animals for domestication. For example, they select those plants and animals that are not prone to diseases. They also select plants that yield large-sized grain and have strong stalks, capable of bearing the weight of ripe grain. Amongst animals, those are gentle. They were selected for breeding. As a result, gradually domesticated animals and plants became different from wild animals and plants. For example, the teeth of horns of wild animals were usually much larger than those of domesticated animals. Domestication was a gradual process that took place in many parts of the world. It began about 12,000 years ago. All the plant and animals produced that we use as food today is a result of domestication. Some of the earliest plants to be domesticated were wheat and barley. The earliest domesticated animals that include sheep and goat.